talk about how all this started with your special bowling program and your competition.
Okay. I started a special needs ballroom dance class after seeing my son, Matthew, dancing with all the students here at the studio. And he was about 6 years old, and I started a free class and had about six adults. And that class has grown to now having 63
wow.
adults. Some of my typical students are volunteering their time and talent dancing with all of the students. And I wanted to have them be able to compete in a ballroom dance competition, but there really wasn't a category in the national ballroom competition. Yeah. So I decided to start my own. And once a year we have a special ballroom festival, and the students can compete in whatever dances they choose to compete, and we categorize with ability, just like the typical students, mm-hmm. the typical competitions do. So
how did your class grow when you got your first six? Was that just word of mouth, people you knew?
Actually, what I started with the Down Syndrome Association of Greater Cincinnati, and so they posted it in their program, and that's how the first six came about. And I think it was just word of mouth that it kept growing and growing. And the different counties, I began to touch base with the Hamilton County DDS and Butler County and Claremont County. So now I have students from all three counties who attend the classes. I do two classes a week. I call it happy hour. I have one on Tuesdays from 6 to 6:45 and one on Wednesdays from 6 to 6:45.
So how many years?
This has been 10 years now. Yeah.
How many years into it before you started your competition?
This will be the fourth year. So I guess I did the classes for about 6 years. Mm-hmm. And we started a fundraiser. We became a nonprofit organization back in 2007. So that's probably been 10 years since mm-hmm. that also. And because one of my students asked if she was good enough to be on Dancing with the Stars, and I said, absolutely. So we used that opportunity to do an annual fundraiser, and 100% of the money goes back to the students for outfits and shoes and t-shirts, sweatshirts, dance attire. And we just entered a Special Olympic dance sport competition in Indiana, and it funded that also.
Will this be your first time going there?
That was the first time we were up there.
That
was just,
for a while. Touched that a few years.
Yeah. They came down to ours. I don't know if you remember that, maybe
yes.
2 years ago. Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
So it doesn't always work in my schedule, but one of my volunteers, it worked in hers and her husband. So they went up with one of the students to see what it was like.
And they run theirs a little different.
Yeah. Yeah.
It's nice that you have your own special one that you can run. Because you run yours more like a regular competition.
Right, right.
People actually are cut from one heat to the next.
Right, and some of the students do try their hardest and get upset when they don't
mm-hmm.
get, which is just like any other person.
That's life.
Yeah, that's how you learn. That's right.
And last year, you had some people dancing together that were not with one of your other students.
Two couples that are, I believe, all four of them have Down syndrome, and the two couples are married. One couple had just started recently, and the other couple has been with us for probably about 5 years, and I think they just celebrated their 11th anniversary, if I'm not mistaken.
Yeah.
They're so cute, but they prefer to dance with each other. And that's great.
What are your age ranges?
Matthew is the youngest. He just turned 16. And my oldest student, who has not been here for probably, I'm going to say 6 months or so, maybe even longer, is 62. I think she's had some little bit of health issues, but Yeah, 16 to 62.
And they're all in the same class?
Well, I have the two classes now.
Okay. Do you separate them?
No, I don't separate anybody because I only have a couple that are under 21. The rest are all over 21. They're adults with disabilities.
And what kind of disabilities do you have?
You know, the majority is some type of a mental disability that ranges from a Down syndrome to cerebral palsy to autism. I don't ask, it doesn't matter.
Mm-hmm. And you do have some people in wheelchairs.
Yes, I have a young lady with cerebral palsy and another lady who was in an accident who has Down syndrome.
And do you teach differently according to what particular issue they're dealing with? I know the one gal has a hula hoop around her.
One of my students designed a hoop to help us as a volunteer or someone who was dancing with her to make it a little bit easier to travel around the floor. But I do the same with all of them. We do the exact same thing.
Do you have anything different this year at your competition? Are you making changes?
I really am not making changes. We have a couple new line dances. As the songs come out on the radio, they love to dance. So I try to keep that current. Mm-hmm. But that's it. I do the same.
So this year, when is your competition?
October 7th at Sharonville Convention Center on Chester Road here in Sharonville.
Okay.